Hi friends, good morning everyone. So my name is Indra and you are watching Indra Virtual Education channel. So continuation of the class. So fifth problem. So in a right angle triangle PQR, right angle at Q and PQ equals to 6 centimeters, angle RPQ equals to 60 degrees. So we have to determine the length of the QR and PR. So in the solution, what we are writing, given that in a right angle triangle PQR, so right angle at Q, so PQ equals to 6 centimeters and angle RPQ equals to 60 degrees. So by using the right angle triangle, so this is the right angle triangle, so angle RPQ, so P at 60 degrees, so this is the 60 degrees, so perpendicular to this 90 degrees, so R, P and Q, so this is the opposite side, this one is the adjacent side, and this one is the hypotenuse. So what is given? So is given that PQ. So PQ equals to how many centimeters? 6 centimeters. So we know that Pythagoras theorem. So hypotenuse square equals to opposite square plus adjacent whole square. So we have to find out what we have to find out. We have to find out the value of QR. So we have to find out the value of QR. For this one, we are taking tan 60 degrees. So we are finding out tan 60 degrees equals to what is the tan 60 degrees? So opposite by adjacent. What is the opposite side? Opposite side is RQ and the adjacent side is 6. So tan 60 degrees equals to opposite by adjacent, that is RQ by 6. So tan 60 degrees value is root 3. So root 3 equals to RQ by 6. So cross multiplication, RQ equals to 6 root 3 centimeters. This one we are taking as first equation. So we have got the value of RQ. Now we have to find out the value of PR. So we have to find out the value of PR also. So for this we are taking sine 60 degrees. So we are doing sine 60 degrees. Sine 60 degrees value is opposite by hypotenuse. So sine 60 degrees is opposite by hypotenuse. So opposite is RQ, hypotenuse is RP. So sine 60 degrees value is root 3 by 2 is equals to RQ by RP. We know the RQ value. So what is the RQ value? RQ equals to 6 root 3 centimeters. So root 3 by 2 equals to 6 root 3 by RP. Now do the cross multiplication. So what we will get? Now see. So RP equals to, we are taking root 3 of the left hand side to the denominator of the right hand side. So RP equals to 6 root 3 by root 3. So we are taking denominator to the right hand side. So it goes to the numerator into 2. So root 3 would get cancelled. So RP value we are getting 12 centimeters. So finally we got the both the answers. So what we have to find out? We have to find out the length of RQ. So length of RQ is how much? 6 root 3 centimeters, as well as length of RP. RP or PR. So we got the answer, final answer, 12 centimeters. And so the sixth problem. So in the right angle triangle XYZ, right angle is at Y. So YZ equals to X and XY equals to 2X. So we have to determine angle YXZ and YZX. So in the solution we have to note that in the problem we are taking as yx equals to x and xz equals to 2x. So given that in right angle triangle xyz, right angle at y, so yx equals to x and xz equals to 2x. So by Pythagoras theorem, so we know that by Pythagoras theorem, so hypotenuse square equals to opposite square plus adjacent whole square. So hypotenuse is 2x whole square equals to opposite side is yz whole square plus adjacent side is x whole square. So 4x whole square means, so 2 to the 4x into x become 4x square. So yz whole square plus x square. So take x square to left hand side, it becomes, so 4x square minus x square equals to yz whole square. So write on reverse. So yz whole square equals to 4x square minus x square is 3x square. So take square to right hand side becomes root. So yz equals to square root of 3x square. So write on the root separately, you will get yz equals to root 3. So square root will be cancelled. So you will get the answer yz equals to root 3x. So we got the yz value is root 3x. So we are doing in right angle triangle yxz. So we are doing tan x. So tan x equals to opposite. So this one is the opposite side, this one is the adjacent side, and this one is the hypotenuse side. So tan x equals to opposite by adjacent. So what is that? Tan x equals to opposite side is root 3x by adjacent is x. So xx will be get cancelled, will get tan x equals to root 3. So tan x equals to root 3. So when it get root 3, tan 60 degrees value is root 3. So tan will get cancelled. So we will get the answer x equals to 60 degrees. So therefore, so angle yxz is 60 degrees. Now we are doing right angle triangle yzx. So tan z, so with respect to tan z we are doing, so tan z equals to opposite side will become xy and the adjacent side will become yz. So tan z equals to xy root 3x, xx will be get cancelled. So tan z equals to 1 by root 3. So tan z equals to tan 30 degrees. Tan 10 will be answered. So we will get the answer z equals to 30 degrees. Therefore, angle yzx is 30 degrees. So what we are writing finally? Therefore, angle yxz is 30 degrees and angle yzx is, so angle yzx is 60 degrees and angle yzx is 30 degrees. So this is the solution. Now see the seventh problem. Is it right to say that sin a plus b equals to sin a plus sin b? Justify your answer. So in these solutions we are taking that a equals to 30 degrees and b equals to 60 degrees. So we are taking sin a plus b. Sin a plus b equals to, we have to prove that sin a plus sin b. So this one we are taking as LHS. So LHS is, we are taking sin a plus b. So sin 30 degrees plus 60 degrees equals to sin 90 degrees. So sin 90 degrees value is 1. So we are doing now RHS, sin a plus b, sin a plus sin b, sin 30 degrees plus sin 60 degrees. So sin 30 degrees value is 1 by 2, sin 60 degrees value is root 3 by 2. Both the denominators are same, we will get the denominator 2. So in the numerator 1 plus root 3. So therefore LHS is different, RHS is different. Therefore, LHS is not equals to RHS. So therefore, it is not too right to say that sin A plus B is equals to sin A plus sin B. Why? Because we have got the LHS answer is 1 and the RHS answer is 1 plus root 3 by 2. So both LHS and RHS both are different. So therefore LHS is not equals to RHS. So therefore we are writing, so it is not right to say that sin A plus B equals to sin A plus sin B. So if you want to watch more videos on my channel, please subscribe to my channel and press the bell icon. So if you want to watch the previous videos, so you can check in the I cards, so which I have given on the top of the videos. So thank you.